So now we're going to go in and perform the shaft alignment function using our RT-300. Now, we're going to make this assumption. I pulled the guard off here, and this was grossly misaligned, like you'll often find. Maybe the coupling's chewed up, and you're going to have to replace it. I've already performed some rough and in steps just to get it a little closer. Doesn't matter for the laser. The laser will more than adequately measure, you know, half inch of misalignment. 10 millimeters off, it wouldn't make any difference. But I want to rough it in to minimize forces in the coupling, so I'm not deflecting shafts any. So now let's go ahead and mount our laser on here. We're going to do an alignment check. So I'll turn on my M sensor, mount it to the machine. And again, we're just simulating this because this is just a little small motorized demonstrator. But the process, it would be exactly the same if it was a 1,000 horsepower machine. I'll mount my S sensor. Just kind of getting roughly in the same angular position on each one. It isn't critical now. We'll actually let the laser tell us what our relative angles are on each sensor. I'll get them snug. I'm going to go into the shaft alignment app. We'll let it start up, let it pair to the sensors. So we paired up to the sensors, got our beams flashing. You can tell my relative angular positions of each sensor. I'm going to give these adjusting knobs about a half turn just to make sure that they don't accidentally slip during the alignment process. So now I'm going to touch on the measure application here. And it wants to know how far the heads are apart from each other, from the center of the M sensor rods to the center of the S sensor rods, are 3.5 inches. So I'll put that value in. Wants to know how far it is from the M sensor to center of coupling. That isn't quite as critical a measurement, but I need to try to get it close as I can, and I will call that 1.5 inches. Third dimension is from the M sensor to the center of the inboard feet where the shims would go, and that is 2 inches. And lastly, distance from the center of the inboard foot to the center of the outboard foot. And on this machine, that is 6.75 inches. Last thing I need to tell it is the running speed. We're just going to make an assumption. This is a 3600 machine. So we will align to that value. And now we're ready to take our measurements. Now, typically, I always like to rotate in the direction of rotation or rotate my shafts for the measurement. Don't really have to, it's just a habit of mine. So I'm going to roll all the way over to one side, check my angles, and they are within 0.5 degree or so they're pretty close. So I will tell it to measure. It's going to show me the image, showing me, giving me some guidance on where to go with it. And I'm going to take the first measurement. It only takes just a moment, and now I need to rotate it at least 30 degrees in one way or the other. In this case, I'm going to rotate it up straight up to vertical. I have a little backlash in my coupling, so I have to control that. I'm just going to put this sensor in the lead, and that'll clear that and get these very close to being the same. I'll take my second measurement. And lastly, I'm going to rotate over here somewhere in the horizontal position. And I will take the third measurement. And obviously, we do have an alignment problem. We're going to save this because you always want documentation. And we will name this machine Fan 1 as found. And now that I've saved the data, is I want to go to the shim icon, and it tells me I need to add 21 thousandths under the two inboard feet, 77 thousandths under the two outboard feet. So let's do that. So now I've added in the shims that I need to correct it vertically. I want to go into live mode now, and I'm going to correct it horizontally. Now I'm going to use my magnetic base for my dial indicator as a steady rest. I'm simply going to adjust it so it will hold my sensors in a horizontal position so I can make the horizontal move hands off. This way I don't have to hold the machine up and try to hold them still at once. I go by the guidance on my RT-300 and it tells me that I need to move the machine that direction. So I'll start using jacking bolts, being careful not to overshoot it because I don't want to make extra work for myself. I just want to get it where it needs to be. And again, we're not shooting for zeros. We just want to get our alignment in tolerance. So that looks pretty good. And now we will start finger tightening bolt number 1, 2, 3, and 4. And now I'm going to go back to 1 and snug it just a little. Don't want to be too powerful with this because you can accidentally move the motor around a bit. So we're just being very cautious about how we tighten this up. The smaller it is, the more critical that is. So now I'm going to tighten 1. Go to 2. I'll go to 3. And then lastly, I'll go to 4. Now, if we did our part, we should have a pretty good alignment here. So let's remeasure and see. So now I'm going to hit the remeasure key and tell it I want to take one more measurement. I'm in a pretty good place right here using this steady rest, or this dial mag base as a steady rest. So I'll go into the measurement icon and it tells me to rotate over to there. I've done that already, so we'll take our first measurement. I'm going to rotate up to at least 30 degrees, somewhere out of that position. We'll take our second measurement. And we'll take one more rotation to get our third measurement. And now we have a good alignment. So it's a really quick process, on-screen guidance. We just follow the instructions on the RT, use a little common sense with this, and we've done a quick alignment job. Now, do we want to save this? Obviously we do, because I want to show a before and after. So I just go back into the save icon, and I'm going to name this machine Final. And so now I have both the before and after saved, and I've got documentation showing that I have aligned the machine. So now that we've aligned it, what do you think we're going to do? We're going to do another vibration test on it and see if we've improved the vibration levels on it.